Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have discussed about the hydrolysis of the various derived salts, that is from a different weak acid or strong acid or strong acid or weak base, and now we are going to discuss about what is the hydrolysis of the salt of weak acid and weak base. So let's talk about it. So now, before understanding that hydrolysis of salt of weak acid and weak base, so let us discuss about a salt which is derived from a weak acid and weak base. So in that case, I would name it as like CH3COONH4. So this is the one that we know, and suppose if this undergoes dissociation, because if it is a salt, it will dissociate completely, and it is made up of, that is, a weak acid, that is, I would call it as a CH3COOH, and along with that of the NH4OH, because the both are weak acid and weak base, and that's the reason this salt has been originated, and it will dissociate into basically CH3COO- along with that of, that is, NH4+. And now, if it has been reacted with that of water, and water, as we know, that is, it is the weak electrolyte, so therefore a pure water is a weak electrolyte, so therefore it will dissociate into H+ and along with that of the OH-, but there will be formation of an equilibrium. So now we are letting the reaction to happen with that is the CH3CO NH4, that is ammonium acetate, to that of the water. So let us see that what happens and what will be effect in the concentration of the H+ ion or the OH-, and let us talk about that. So in this case, basically what happens is, when we dissociate or when we dissolve basically the ammonium acetate, that is CH3COONH4, that will dissociate into this ions, that is NH4+, and this is what it is reacted with, H2O. So it has been found that in this process, that is the combination of, that is, CH3COO-, that is acetate, that will combine with that of the hydrogen ions of the water, so as to form basically CH3COOH, forming a weak acid, and along with that, that is NH4+, it will combine with that of the OH- ion of the water molecule, so as to form basically NH4OH. So here, in this case, basically the weak acid and weak base, the both are being formed, and the both have a similar extent to combine with their respective ions, and that's the reason that we could say that the H+ ion concentration that has been utilized because of the acetate ion, and the OH- ion that has been utilized because of the NH4+ ion, they both will be the same. So the extent of the utilization, the both will be the same, and hence we could say that the concentration of the H+ ion and that of the OH- ion that has been remaining, or that has been ionized for water, it will remain the same, and that is the reason that we could say that the concentration of the both the ions, that is H+ ion and the OH- ion, are the same, and hence the solution would be neutral. So now we could say, in this case, basically the solution will be neutral, and in this case, basically the H+ ion concentration and that of the OH- ion concentration, the both will be the same, and that's the reason that we could say that the pH is equals to 7. And the solution is neutral. So usually what happens is, even though if we are adding a weak acid and weak base, it is not necessary that we will get a neutral solution. It will depend on the Ka and Kb. So what is that? It is, obviously we have did it in our previous lecture. It is nothing but the dissociation constant for a weak acid and the dissociation constant for a weak base. So it will depend on that. Because in this neutral solution that we have got over here, and while taking these examples, that is a weak acid like acetic acid and a weak base like NH4OH, that is ammonium hydroxide. So in this case, it has been found that the dissociation constant of the weak acid and the dissociation constant for weak base, the both are same. That is the reason that at proper extent, we could get the utilization of H+ ions and the OH- ion, and leading to the maintenance of the H+ ion and the OH- ion concentration to be as it is, or unchanged, or be, because we could say the both will be the same, and that's what I have expressed over here, and that is the reason that the solution becomes neutral. But the weak acid can have more dissociation constant compared to that of the weak base, and in that case, what will happen? So let's find it out. So this was the first case that we have talked about when Ka was equals to Kb. And what if we have a situation where we are including a weak acid as well as a weak base, in which basically the Ka is basically more than that of the Kb. So let me talk about this one. Suppose if I am taking an example in this case, like that of the when an salt like that of NH4F, if I am talking about this one. So this is the one that is made up of a weak acid as well as a weak base. So this is the salt that has been derived from that. And if that has been reacted with that of water, so obviously the first thing is it will dissociate completely because it is a strong electrolyte if we are talking in that manner. So therefore it will convert into that is NH4 plus along with that of the F minus. So this is it. And suppose if we are reacting with that of the water, so therefore this is the one that has been ionized, and that's the reason that NH4 plus along with that of the F minus that will dissociate in the water, it will react with the water, that is H2O, so as to give the particular products. And in this case, the particular product that will be that we could form is basically NH4OH and HF. So if we observe that the product that we have got over here is a weak base as well as a weak acid, but since we are talking about the dissociation constant of Ka is more than that of the Kb, so obviously there would be the ionization of the acid to a more extent. So therefore we could say that is this can be written in this form, so as to simplify this one, so that what we are going to do is basically this NH4 plus along with that of the F minus that has been dissociated completely along with that of this H2O. So now what will happen is this NH4OH, because the Kb value is less than that of the Ka, so therefore this will not dissociate that much till that extent, so therefore I'm keeping this value as it is. But HF, because it is being a weak acid, and in that case basically the Ka value is more than that of Kb, so obviously that this will dissociate with a particular extent, and that's the reason that we could find out this one. So in this case the only thing that we have to do is we could balance it by cancelling out this two, and if you observe, then the solution that has been left out or the equation that has been left out is basically NH4 plus that will react with that of the H2O, so as to give basically NH4OH along with that of that is H plus. So if you observe, so this is the equation that we could get, and the thing is basically in this case basically we could get H plus ion concentration. So that would be more than that of the OH minus ion concentration. So even though being a neutral solution it makes, we could see in this case where the K is more than Kb, and in this case the H plus ion goes on increasing, and that's the reason that the solution will become more acidic, and this is the condition that we have. So the solution will be more acidic if K value is more than Kb. And now let us talk about the another one where we could see that is the Ka is less than Kb, or we could say that the value of Kb is more than that of Ka. So in this case, suppose if I'm taking an example like that of like NH4Cl is the salt that I'm talking about, and that will dissociate completely into that is NH4 plus along with that of the Cl minus. And in this case, suppose if it is reacted with that of water, so therefore we could say that NH4 plus and Cl minus, they both will be present in the water. And in this case, suppose a reaction will happen in such a way that we could get that is NH4OH along with that of that is HCl. So the weak base and the weak acid has been formed, and but till which extent the ionization will occur, because there will be competition between these two, and that's the reason that we, if we observe that the Ka value is more the Ka value is less than compared to that of the Kb, then the ionization, or we could say the dissociation of the weak base will be till more extent compared to that of the weak acid. So that's the reason that we could write the above equation in this form, that is NH4 plus along with that of the Cl minus that will react with that of the H2O, so as to form, because this is dissociating till more extent compared to that of the HCl, so therefore we could say that is NH4 plus will dissociate to like this one, and this is the HCl that won't get dissociated. So in this case, basically we could see that is this will cancel out this one, and we could easily observe that the thing that has been left out is Cn minus along with that of the H2 that will give us basically HCN along with that of OH minus. So this is the thing that we have got over here, and this clearly indicates that the concentration of OH minus, it goes on increasing, because in this reaction basically the OH minus has been produced and the H plus ion has been utilized so as to form that is HCN. So meanwhile, the OH minus ion concentration that goes on increasing, and that's the reason that the solution will become more basic and the pH value will be more than 7. So that's it. This is the condition that I was talking about, that is hydrolysis of a salt which is derived from a weak acid as well as a weak base. So that's it I wanted to talk about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you'll share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.